工程师声明正道。
The name of the Lord Jesus, the best testimony of the word.
早上我要跟大家继续来讲伊丽莎的神迹。
This morning I would like to continue to share on the topic of the miracles of Elisha.
那就是乃曼的大麻风病从神的恩典医治好了。
And today, we shall study on Naaman's blessings, how his leprosy was healed by God.
他的故事我们大家都很熟悉。
We are all very familiar with the story.
乃曼他并不是神的选民。
Naaman was not a chosen one of God.
他是亚兰人。
He was an Syrian.
亚兰国也常常欺负以色列国。
And the Syrians were waging war against the Israelites.
但是当乃曼来祈求真神的时候，真神也一样的施恩典给他。
But when Naaman came before the Lord to ask for the grace of God, God bestowed grace upon him.
这说明一个很重要的道理。
So this gives us a very important teaching.
我们的神不只是全能的，他也是慈爱的。
That our God is not only a powerful God, He is also a kind and loving God.
不管是什么人，也不管他做错了什么事。
Regardless of who the person is or what wrong he has done.
只要他真心悔改，来归向真神，依靠真神，他就能够得到神的恩典。
As long as he truly repents and trusts in God, rely on God and turn back to God, God will forgive him and bestow his grace on him.
在圣经里面也很记载的很清楚，乃曼蒙恩也有其他的原因。
The Bible also recorded very clearly the other reasons why Naaman was able to receive grace.
那这些原因是什么呢？
So what are some of these reasons?
请看列王记下第五章。
Let's turn to 2 Kings chapter 5.
第一节。
Verse 1.
列王记下第五章第一节。
Second Kings chapter 5 verse 1. Now Naaman, commander of the army of the king of Syria, was a great and honorable man in the eyes of his master, because by him the Lord had given victory to Syria. He was also a mighty man of valor, but he was a leper.
这里记载乃曼是亚兰王的元帅，在他主人面前为君为大。
So here it says that Naaman was the commander of the army of the king of Israel, and he was a great and honorable man.
因为他为国家打了很多的胜战。
Because he had fought several victorious battles for his country.
所以他是一个有崇高权位和财富的人。
Thus he was a man of high status and great wealth.
他得到人民的尊敬和羡慕是他们的英雄。
He was respected and admired in the eyes of the people. He was their hero.
这样的一个大人物，他怎么还会来去祈求神呢？
So how would such a great man come before the Lord and defeat God?
只等到他长了大麻风。
He would do so when he had leprosy.
在当时这是个没有办法医治的疾病，让他实在是痛苦万分。
At that time, leprosy was an incurable disease, and Naaman was in great pain.
他是个大能的勇士，也是常胜将军，但是他却没有办法。也没有能力来胜过他的疾病和痛苦。
He was a great warrior and a commander of the army, but he was not able to do anything to relieve himself of his suffering.
他有极大的荣耀和财富，但是又怎么样呢？摆在他前面的只是一个悲惨的结局啊。
He had great glory and wealth, but what could he do before him laid tragic end?
在这个时候，他就谦卑下来了。
So at that time, he humbled himself.
他知道他的权柄、他的财富、他的一切都不能够帮助他的。
He realized that his power and his wealth, or and everything else that he had, could not help him.
人没有办法依靠自己这一切的才能和要依靠真神。
Man is not able to rely on his own wealth; he has to rely on God.
所以苦难其实就是医治人灵魂的一种良药。
Hence, suffering is actually a kind of meditation for the soul of man.
也许对我们的肉体没有益处，可是对我们的灵性却是大有帮助。
It may not be helpful or beneficial to our physical body, but it is very beneficial for our spiritual life.
让我们懂得世上的一切都不可靠的，也不可信的。
It makes us realize and be aware that all the things that we have on earth are not cannot be trusted upon.
让我们的心能够真正的醒悟，而依靠在那位真神，那才是真正可信靠的。
It wakes up our hearts and our minds to realize that only, that God is the only one whom we can trust on.
圣乃曼能够蒙恩，是因为苦难临到。
Therefore, Naaman was able to receive grace because suffering came upon him.
没有这个苦难的引导，他怎么会来到神的面前来敬拜真神呢？
Without the guidance of this suffering, how would he have been able to come before God to worship God?
其实在苦难当中，我们不是埋怨，反倒我们更应当的来亲近神，来全心全意来依靠真神。
Thus, in the midst of suffering, not only should we not murmur against God, we should come before God. And draw near to God to worship God.
这样你像乃曼一样能够在神的面前蒙恩的。
Then like Naaman, you will be able to receive grace from God.
好，第二个原因。
And the second reason.
我们看第二节。跟第三节。
Let's read verses 2 and 3. Verse 2 and verse 3. And the Syrians had gone out in rage and had brought back captive a young girl from the land of Israel. She waited on Naaman's wife. Then she said to her mistress, "If only my master were with the prophet who is in Samaria." For he would heal him of his leprosy.
乃曼蒙恩的第二个原因，就是因为有这个小女子的见证。
So the second reason why Naaman was able to receive grace was because there was this testimony from the young girl.
你想，如果没有这个小女子的见证，乃曼会来认识先知，来寻求真神吗？
Without the testimony from this young girl, would Naaman have been able to know God and to come before God and the prophet?
所以你不要以为你只不过是一个小女子。你什么都不懂，什么都不会。
So we should not look down on this little girl and say that she's young and she doesn't know anything.
在乃曼蒙恩这个神迹里面，这个小女子扮演一个很重要的角色。
In this miracle of Naaman receiving grace, this young girl played a critical role.
但问题是，为什么乃曼会这样轻信这样一个卑女的见证呢？
The question now is, how was Naaman able to listen to this young girl?
那一定是乃曼的妻子很相信这个卑女的话。
It must have been because Naaman's wife believed in the words of this girl.
这个小女子是服侍乃曼的妻的。
This young girl waited on Naaman's wife.
她对她的祖母说，巴不得我主人去见撒玛利亚的先知，他必能够医好她的大麻风。
And she said to her mistress,If only my master were with the prophet who is in Samaria, for he would heal him of his leprosy.
他的妻子就告诉他的丈夫。
So the wife went to tell her husband.
他丈夫也这样的相信了。
And her husband believed.
他们这样相信这个小女子是有原因的。
And there was reason why they believed the young girl.
在府里面有很多从各地如来的那一些小女子做仆婢。
At that time, there were many young girls who had been taken captive and were brought back to be slaves.
那这个小女子的生活见证是跟别人不一样的。
So the life of this girl was a testimony that she was different from the rest of the other girls.
你可以看得出她对神的信心。
You can see her faith in God.
既然她已经可以说是家破人散。
Although she was homeless.
那应该说你的神都没有保护你，那你还要拜这个神吗？
One could say to her that your God has not protected you. Why should you still believe in him?
可是她并不因此而埋怨真神。
However, she did not murmur against God because of this.
反倒她还见证神的大能呢。
On the contrary, she bore testimony of the greatness of God.
我所敬拜的真神会医好你的大麻风病，他有这个权柄的。
The God whom I believe in will be able to cure you of your leprosy.
而且她也相信乃曼虽然是死到他的国家。灭亡失败的，但是他相信神还是会与你这个仇敌的，只要他悔改。
And he believed that although Naaman and his country were the ones who had taken captives of herself and her people, she believed that God will still be be gracious to Naaman and heal him.
如果一个这样让你痛苦的人，你肯愿意为他祷告，甚至为他传福音，让他得到神的恩典吗？
If there was such a person who has caused you such great suffering and pain, would you still be able to pray for him?
或者你自己本身都得不到什么保护，你在这种痛苦当中，你还要再认为见证我的神是慈爱的，我的神是有能力的吗？
Or if you yourself have not been protected by God, could you still stand up and bear witness that your God is all powerful and kind?
你看这些基督徒在信仰生活里面遇到一些试探。
We see some Christians who have met with trials in their life.
有一些失败啦，有一些失业啦。
Some have met with failures. Some have lost their jobs.
有一些感情上失恋啦。
Some have fallen out of love.
或者有一些在身体上有病痛啦。
Or some have some are sick.
那在这种情况之下，我们通常都会埋怨神的。
And under such circumstances, we would normally murmur against God.
为什么神不祝福我、保护我呢？
Why does God not protect me and bless me?
有些人在失望当中，甚至也失去了信心。
And some people lose their faith in the midst of failure.
因此，在这样的情况之下，他怎么样来去见证神的大能呢？
But under such a circumstance, how was he able to bear testimony for the God, for God?
过着这种埋怨失望的生活，那要他就怎么样来做美好的见证，说神是我们的救主？
If he had led such a life of murmuring against God, how would he have been able to bear testimony that our God is great God?
因此我们生活上的见证是很重要的。
Therefore, the witnesses of our life is very important.
人家看你怎样的拜神。
When people observe how you worship God,
人家看你怎样的面对种种的苦难。
Others observe how you deal with the sufferings and pain that you meet with.
所以乃曼他们冷眼旁观，看到这个小女子那一种特别的生活见证。
So when Naaman saw how this girl conducted herself in the midst of such suffering,
他们相信他所说的神真的是真神。
He believed that this God whom he spoke about is the true God.
因此他们就去求靠神了。
Therefore, they went to beseech God.
所以在信仰生活里面，我们的生活能不能够让人家看出我们的神是真的神、活的神呢？
So in our lives of faith, are we able to let others see that our God is true and living God?
我们的生活见证能够带领人来认识神的，就像这个小女子带领这个买卖来认识神一样。
Our lives can be a testimony to lead people to God.Just like this young girl.
好，乃曼蒙恩的第三个原因。
The third reason why Naaman was able to receive grace
是因为他有一个好仆人的劝导。
Was because he had the good advice of good servant.
我们读十二节到十三节。
Let's read verses 12 and 13. Are not the Abana and the Pharpar, the rivers of Damascus, better than all the waters of Israel? Could I not walk in them and be clean?So he turned and went away in a rage. And his servants came near and spoke to him and said, My father, if the prophet had told you to do something great, would you not have done it? How much more then when he says to you, Wash and be clean? When he went to meet the prophet,
先知派仆人告诉他，你去约旦河洗去回，你的病就完全得到医治了。
The prophet sent a messenger to him and said, Go and wash in the Jordan 7 times and your flesh shall be restored.
他就很生气了。
So he became furious.
当时的约旦河水并不是很干净的水。
At that time, the waters of River Jordan were not clean.
说真的，它是比国家的两条河的水啊，都比以色列的水好。
In fact, the rivers in his own country have cleaner water than the waters of Israel.
所以他认为以利沙先知是故意在为难他，取笑他。
So he felt that Prophet Elisha was making things difficult for him and making a mockery of him.
你欺负我们的国家，现在你又来求我们的神来帮助你，哪有这么便宜的事情？
First, you have defeated our country, and now you want to come and beseech our God to heal you. How can you get away so easily?
但是他的仆人在这个时候对他说。
But at that time, his servant said to him,
他说我父啊，先知如果吩咐你做一件大事，你岂不是要做吗？
He said, My father, if the prophet had told you to do something great, would you not have done it?
为了得到你的医治，就算是更难、更让你为难的事情啊，你都还是要去做的。
In order to be healed, you would do anything that you have to do.
更何况这只不过是件小事吗？就到河里一洗去就好了。
How much more when this thing that he has told you to do is a small thing?
这并不是一个很为难、很委屈的事情啊。
This is actually not very humiliating thing to do.
为什么乃曼会这样想，而他仆人又不会这样想呢？
Why was it that Naaman thought in one manner, while his servant thought in another way?
如果乃曼不是个大元帅，他只是个普通的仆人，你说他会感觉到为难和受委屈吗？
If Naaman was not a great commander, but he was a servant, would he have felt humiliated?
那可见的，原来乃曼心里还有一种骄傲。
So we see that Naaman still had some pride in him.
我从他一直答应说要先到安全的河里面这样放纵下去，这样洗去吃。
How can a great commander like me go and wash myself in this dirty river 7 times?
他放不下他那一种的地位，他的尊严。
He was not able to let go of and put aside his status.
但是
and his pride.
伊丽莎先生知道，神施恩给谦卑的人，但神阻挡骄傲的人。
But Elisha knew that God gives grace to the humble, but opposes the proud.
所以伊丽莎先生呢，是要他完全的谦卑下来，完全的听从神的话。
Therefore, Papa Elisha wanted him to humble himself completely and to be obedient to the word of God.
并不是故意要为难他，让他受委屈啊。
It was not because he wanted to make things difficult for him and mock him.
那他仆人还告诉他一件事。
His servant also told him one more thing.
他说何况先知说你去沐浴你就得洁净了。
How much more when the prophet has said to you wash and be clean.
你要相信先知的话。
You have to believe in the words of the prophet.
乃曼会先的发怒会不听从，就是因为他不相信真的这样子是去洗去吃那个病就会好吗？
Naaman was furious because he did not believe that by washing himself he will be able to be healed.
但是仆人提醒他你应该相信神的话。
But his servant reminded him that he should listen to the word of God.
乃曼他自己有自己的想法的。
Naaman had his own way of thinking.
你看第十一节。
Let's see verse 11.
十一节，乃曼就发怒走了。
But Naaman became furious and ran away.
他说：“我想，他必定出来见我，站着求告他的神的名，或者在饭处以上摇手，治好我这个大麻风。”
And said, Indeed, I said to myself, he will surely come out to me and stand and call on the name of the Lord his God and wave his hand over the place and heal the leprosy. Prophet Elisha does not even want to come out to meet me. He did not pray for me. He did not lay hands upon me.
只是说你去洗去吃就会好了。
He merely told me to go and wash myself and I will be clean.
你去洗身上你应该为我祷告啊，为我按手啊。
At the very least, you should be praying for me and laying hands on me.
而且我的病可能还会好。
In that way, perhaps my disease could be healed.
所以没有先知的祷告，没有先知的按手，怎么会有功效呢？
So without the prayers of the prophet, without the laying on of hands of the prophet, how can this healing be effective?
这大概就是一般人的想法吧。
This is perhaps how the average man would think.
我们也认为只要有一个大能力的先知，好像伊丽莎这样，他的祷告有功效的，他的按手一定得医治的。
We think that as long as there is a great prophet like Prophet Elisha, his prayers will be effective, and his when he lays hands upon you, you will be healed.
但事实上，能力并不是在于先知的按手和祷告啊，能力是在于那一位真神啊。
However, in reality, the power does not lie in the prayers or in the hands of the prophet. Power lies in God.
所以你需要来全心全意依靠真神，向神祈求。
Therefore, you have to wholeheartedly come before God and pray to God.
只要你相信神的话，照神的话去求去行，你就能够蒙神的恩典的。
As long as you believe in the word of God and do according to the word of God and pray to Him.You will receive grace.
就算大有能力的先知，他也一样要听从神的吩咐，他也不是什么都能够做的。
Even a powerful prophet has to be obedient to to God. He cannot do as he wishes.
所以，伊丽莎先知是教导他，你要完完全全的相信神的话。
Therefore, Prophet Elisha taught Naaman that he had to completely and wholeheartedly believe in the word of God.
你是依靠神的手，不是依靠大先知的手和。祷告和按手。
He has to believe in the hands of God and not in the prayers and the hands of the prophet.
所以当他仆人提醒他的时候，他明白了。
So when his servant reminded him, he understood.
他就遵照神的话，他就去沐浴去吃，他的病就好了。
And he obeyed and did according to the word of God, and his illness was cured.
在第十五节里面记载。
And in verse 15, it records.
乃曼就带着一切跟随他的人回到神人伊丽莎那边去。
That he returned to the man of God, he and all his aides.
你看他怎么对先知说。
And see what he said to the prophet.
如今我知道，除了以色列之外，普天下仍有神呢。
He said, Indeed, now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel.
如果先知替他按手祷告，他就感谢先知，敬拜先知。你说他会这样清楚认识这一位 普天下的独一真神吗？
If the prophet had laid hands on him and prayed for him, he would have believed and respected the prophet. Would he have believed in God?
因此我们需要把人带到神的面前，不是带到任何人的面前。
Therefore, we have to lead men before God and not before any other man.
因此仆人适当的劝导是很重要的。
So the appropriate advice of the servant was very important.
有时候我们会因为一时的怒气或者因为一时的忧虑，我们会忽略了很多事情。
Sometimes in a moment of anger or in a moment of depression, we may neglect many things.
我们的确需要旁边的人在适当的时候给我们鼓励，给我们安慰，甚至给我们提醒和责备。
In these times, we will need those who are beside us to encourage us and to remind us to turn back to God.
如果他没有这个好仆人，适当的来劝导他，跟他解释明白。
If Naaman did not have this servant to remind him and advise him,
他就这样的怒之下就走掉了。
He would have walked away in a moment of anger.
还有这个神迹的出现吗？
Would this miracle have come about?
所以圣经告诉我们要互相劝勉。
Therefore, the Bible tells us to encourage one another.
趁着还有机会，要天天彼此相见。
As long as there's today, we should encourage one another daily.
因为我们也会有我们的软弱，也会有我们的怒气，也会有我们失去信心的时候的。
Because there will be times when we ourselves will become weak, when we ourselves will lose our faith.
如果没有人在适当的时候扶他一把，他就正跌倒，甚至就因此而离开了。
And if there's no one by his side to give him that support and encouragement that he needs, he may fall away.
所以我们不只要像这个小使女一样做见证，更要像这个好仆人一样，要互相的劝导和提醒啊。
Therefore, we not only have to be like this young girl to bear testimony of the word, we also have to be like this servant to encourage and advise others.
好，乃曼蒙恩的最重要的一个原因。
The most important reason why Naaman was able to receive grace.
那就是他自己的悔改和顺服。
Was because of his own repentance and submission.
如果他自己不肯谦卑下来悔改，
if he had refused to humble himself and to repent,
那既然有使女的见证，有仆人的劝导，那最后也还是白费心机的。
The testimony of the young girl and the advice of the servant would not have been effective.
乃曼他有一些错误的思想。
Naaman had some erroneous thoughts.
第一个错误的思想是什么呢？
What was the first thought that he had that was wrong?
请看第五节。
Let's read verse 5.
这里记载乃曼带银子十他连的金子六千舍客勒衣裳十套就去了。
So here it says that Naaman departed and took with him 10 talents of silver, 6,000 shekels of gold, and 10 changes of clothing.
他带这么多的钱啊，因为他以为钱可以买到神的恩典。
He brought so much money with him because he thought money could buy the grace of God.
虽然我们的国家欺负以色列国，当然他们会不高兴啊。
Although our country had taken captive of Israel, and the Israelites would definitely not be happy with us.
他部分都会拒绝我的要求的。
他会
拒绝我的要求。
And most likely they will refuse my request.
但是我有钱可以给他。
But if I have this money to give them,
人家说有钱都能够使鬼推磨，更何况我带了这么多钱呢？
And people say that if you have money, even the devil will work for you. So what more if I give this money to men?
你知道这个是多少钱吗？
You know how much this amount of money is worth?
圣列王记上十六章。
In 1 Kings chapter 16.
24节。
Verse 24.
列王记上十六章二十四节。
First Kings chapter 16 verse 24。
这里记载以色列王暗利，他用二他连的银子向撒玛买了撒玛利亚山。
Here it says that the king of Israel bought the hill of Samaria from Shema for 2 talents of silver.
他就在山上造了这个撒玛利亚城。
And he built the city of Samaria on the hill.
你看买整座撒玛利亚山地哦，只是用二他连的银子。
So you see that it only that with 2 talents of silver you can buy the entire hill of Samaria.
那么现在乃曼带了十他连的银子，你可以想象这个数目是何等的庞大。
How much more now Naaman had brought along 10 talents of silver with him.
所以他认为有钱真的是好办事的。
So he really thought that with money he can do anything he wished.
这也不是一般人的想法吗？
And it's not this the thought of most people.
所以当乃曼得到医治的时候，
So when Naaman was healed,
他把很多的礼物通通都送给伊丽莎。
He took all these presents and gifts and presented them to Elijah.
但是伊丽莎先是一点都不要。
But Elijah did not accept that.
虽然乃曼再三的求他收下。
Although Naaman pleaded with him to accept the gift.
通常我们是要求人家来帮助我们啊，怎么我们会求人家来接受我们的帮助的呢？
Usually we would plead with others to help us. Why would we plead with others to accept our gift?
更何况伊丽莎先知他们都是过着穷苦的生活，钱对他们来说的确是很重要的。
And at that time, Elijah and his people were living a hard life and a life of poverty, so wealth or money to them would have been very important.
但是伊丽莎拒绝。
But Elijah rejected.
因为他要告诉乃曼一件事情。
Because he wanted to tell Naaman one thing.
你得到神的恩典，完完全全是属于神的恩典，而不是因为你带来很多的金钱。
That when you receive the grace of God, it is because God has given you this grace, and it is not because you have brought so much gifts and wealth.
钱绝对买不到神的恩典的。
Money will not be able to allow you to buy the grace of God.
我们不要犯上这种同样的错误。
So we should not commit this same mistake.
神啊，帮助我解决这个困难，医好我这个病，那我就要奉献多少钱，多少钱。
God, please tell me all of this difficulty. Please heal me, and I will give you so much money.
这样的想法是很错的。
This manner of thinking is wrong.
因为你以为神的恩典是可以用你的钱来买到的。
Because you think that you can buy the grace of God with your own money.
就好像那些外邦人去拜神一样。
It is like the Gentiles worshiping their God.
他们要用钱来去拜神的。
They have to use money to worship their God.
你要去见那一位大法师，请法术医好你的病，是吗？
You want to go and see that great prophet to heal you of your sickness.
你有钱吗？
Do you have money?
有的，但是钱不够。
I have, but I don't have enough.
那么你就去看我的徒弟吧。
So in that case, go and see my disciples.
那个徒弟如果不喜欢这个数目，那你去见我的徒孙吧。
And if my disciple does not like your, is not happy with the amount that you're giving him, then go and see my grand disciple.
所以你要得到他们神的医治啊，你要带很多很多的钱去见他，你才有希望见到那位所谓大法师啊。
So if you want them to cure you, you have to bring a lot of money with you to give them.
但这样的神值得你去拜吗？
Is such a God worthy of your worship?
有钱就可以买到神的恩典。
As long as you have money, you can buy the grace of God.
难怪天下这么多的恶人在做恶事。
It is no wonder that there are so many evil people committing evil deeds.
因为只要有钱，我就可以得到神的恩典，就可以赦免我的罪了。
Because as long as I have money, I can receive grace from God, and my sins will be forgiven.
我们的神不管你做过什么黑暗的事情，只要你有钱，他就听你的祷告了。
Our God do not care what things you have done. As long as you have money, He will listen to your prayer.
这样的神绝对不是真神。
Such a God cannot be a true God.
没有公义，没有正直的。
There is this God. Such a God has no justice and no righteousness.
所以不要把我们的神与想都是这样的神。
Therefore, we should not think that our God is such a God.
我们只能够谦卑下来，全心全意的祈求神的怜悯和恩典。
We can only humble ourselves down and beseech His grace wholeheartedly.
就好像你们做父母的，儿女要来跟你谈条件啊，以后我做工，我赚到钱，我怎么报答你啊？现在你给我10块钱。
Just like some of us who are parents, the children will they come to you and say, I will do this and that for you, and in return you give me this amount of money.
是这样的关系吗？
Is this is the relationship like that?
那已经就不是一家人的关系了。
If that is so, then it is no longer one family.
好，他第二个错误的观念是什么呢？
And what was his second erroneous way of thinking?
我们看第六节。
Let's see verse 6.Verse 6, then he brought the letter to the king of Israel, who said, Now be advised, when this letter comes to you, that I have sent Naaman my servant to you, that you may heal him of his leprosy.
为什么他要王的这一封信呢？
Why did he want, need this letter from the king?
因为他知道以色列的先知一定会不高兴，我这个大元帅曾经攻打他们，欺负他们的。
Because he knew that the prophet of Israel would not be happy, after all he had this... He was a commander who had defeated his country.
因此我需要亚兰王的信给这个以色列王。
Therefore, I need this letter from the king of Syria to, so that I can pass it to the king of Israel.
由以色列王下命令，叫他的子民以利沙先知遵从命令医好我的病，这不是很容易吗？
So that the king of Israel can command, his citizen, this prophet, to heal him of his illness. So that would have been easy.
所以他以为可以靠着这种权势令先知低头医好他的病呢。
So he thought that he could, count on such authority to make the prophet, bow down and heal him of his sickness. The king of Syria.
第四节是在以色列王看到信就撕裂衣服说我岂是神我怎么能够死人死死人活呢
Verse 7 This time when the king of Israel read the letter he tore his clothes and said Am I God to kill and make alive
我怎么能够医好他的大麻风
How can I heal him of his leprosy
所以他说你们看一看这个人何以行事攻击我呢
Therefore please consider and see how he takes a quarrel with me
亚兰王他还听说以色列有先知可以医好他的病，他马上就写信去了。
When the king of Syria heard that there was a prophet in Israel who could heal Naaman of his leprosy, he immediately wrote a letter.
他也听过以利沙先知的事。
He has heard of works of prophet Elisha.
以色列国本身就很多神迹奇事见证耶和华真神。
There were many miracles and testimonies of in the land of Israel of God.
如果他根本都不相信啊，你说他要写这一封信吗
？If he had not believed in this, would he have written the letter?
但是以色列王自己他反倒不相信，我们的国中真的有人能够医好他的病？我们的神真的会这样说吗
？Yet the king of Israel did not believe. He could not believe that that his God would be able to heal this man of his leprosy, nor that someone in his country would be able to.
但是人就是这样矛盾的。
So Man is always so contradictory.
你看他自己所说的话。
Look at his own words.
说我怎么是神，能够使人死，使人活。
He said, "Am I God to kill and make alive?"
反过来说，你不是在见证神才有权柄叫人死，叫人活，对吗
？On the other hand, aren't you supposed to witness that God is the God who can give life and who can take away life?
你真的不能，但是神能，那你就依靠神来求神就好了嘛。
If you cannot, you know that God can, so all you have to do is to pray to God.
所以我们只是在那边埋怨，不能不能，但是我们却不会安下我们的心，来依靠那一位能做的神啊。
So really, we keep murmuring that we can't do it, but we do not quieten down our heart to pray to God and believe that God can do it.
真的，我们的环境不好了。
Our environment or circumstances may not be good.
我们很多东西都不能够做了。
There are many things that we cannot do.
是不是在这样的时候，你是不是更应该要专心专一的来依靠真神
？So shouldn't you rely on God even more in such circumstances?
反倒在这个时候，我们竟然忘了神，所以我们的愁苦就增加了。
Yet we always tend to forget God when in such a circumstance.
如果我们能够真的把一切交托给神
，If we are able to entrust everything to God,
至低限度，我们的心就安静下来。
At the very least, our hearts were quiet.Quieten down.
到了这个地步。到了这个地步。
And after that,
我们只能够依靠神了。
So when we come to this point, we can only rely on trusting God.
好像德国的那个纳粹逼迫这些犹太人的时候。
Just like when the Nazis were persecuting the Jews.
那些犹太人的家庭啊，都要到处过着逃亡的生活。
The Jews had to flee and to flee.
晚上都不能够安心睡觉。
They were not able to sleep in peace.
有一个脚步声走过，都会提心吊胆，是什么人的脚步声呢
？And whenever they hear footsteps passing by, they became frightened and wondered who these people were.
你要等到脚步声走过了，你才知道哦，原来是路人经过，你才安心下来啊。
Only when the sounds of these footsteps have passed.Will you be able to become again?
如果他来了是在那边敲门，你的心错得更厉害了。
If the footstep was to stop inside the door and someone was to knock on the door, then your heart would jump even faster.
开门一看原来是熟人，你的心又才安定下来。
And when you open the door and realize it's someone you know, you are relieved.
你看每天每时每刻都要过着这个生活，你的身体承受得了吗
？So every day at every moment of the day, they have to live in fear.
所以他们只好祷告求神了。
Therefore, they could only pray to God.
那后来有一次， 终于真的警察来了，也真的把他们抓起了。
And there was one occasion when the police finally came and caught them.
那这个做爸爸的是对他的孩子们说。
So the father said to his children.
孩子啊，现在我们可以安心睡觉了。
Children, now we can finally sleep in peace.
我们不用再提心吊胆了。
We do not have to worry and fear anymore.
我们可以全心靠神了。
We can wholeheartedly completely rely on God.
有些孩子还不懂为什么被抓了，我们反倒安心睡觉呢？
And some of the children did not understand and said, why is it that we can sleep in peace when we have been caught?
为什么被抓了我们才全心靠神呢？
Why should we only trust in God when we are caught?
被抓了我们还靠什么神？
If we have been caught, why should we still continue to trust in God?
他一个意思是告诉他们。
So his intention was to tell the children.
到了这种地步，我们人不能够再做什么了。
That when they have come to that point, there is nothing else that they could do.
你没有再好逃了。
There was no way they could run away.
所以前面的生活是生是死，你真的只好完全交托给神了。
So whether the road ahead will lead you to life or to death, you can only trust in God.
如果神要拯救我们，让我们活下去，我们终于会活下去的，会脱离这个苦难的。
If God wants to save us and allow us to live on, we will be saved and escape from this suffering.
如果我们也因此要死在集中营里面，那我们也应该是接受了。
But if we have to die in this prisoners of war camp, then we will have to accept it.
所以关岛在这个时候，他的心安定下来，真的全心全意把一切交托给神了。
So at that time, he was able to calm down and to leave everything to God.
这就是真正的信靠。
And that is true trust.
如果我们选择用自己的方法，当然可以呀、啊。但是你却会整天在那边提心吊胆，你的心放不下的。
If we want to think of a way ourselves, we can do so, but we will not be able to live to be at ease.
所以以色列王，你就可以看出他的信心。他在那边烦恼，在那边埋怨，在那边呱呱叫，因为他心里根本都没有这种平安的信号啊。
So we see that the king of Israel was murmuring and he was troubled and sorrowed because he did not have this peace in his heart.
所以你要乃曼想要依靠王的势力。来叫先知圣父医治他的病，那根本是错误的。
So Naaman was wrong in thinking that he could rely on the authority of the king to make the prophet Elijah cure him of his illness.
我们也不要有这种想法。
We should not have such way of thinking.
你所依靠的是什么呢？
What is it that you trust in and rely on?
你又以为你因为大有势力的人可以做你的靠山吗？
Do you think there is some great man out there who can who is your support?
有一天靠山靠不住的时候，你要怎么办呢？
And when you can no longer count on this person, what would you do?
神才是我们真正的靠山呢。
Only God is our true support.
但是为什么我们却不依靠他呢？
So why do we not rely on him?
好，最后一个错误的原因。
And the last his Naaman's last thought, that his way of thinking.
他以为他可以靠着他的好行为得到神的恩典。
Was that he thought he could receive grace from God by his good conduct?
他有什么好行为？
What good conduct did he have?
请看第九节。
This is verse 9.
这里说，乃曼带着车马到了以利沙的家，站在门口。
The Naaman ran with his horses and chariot, and he stood at the door of the house of Elijah.
虽然这是很简单的一种态度表现啊，但是对乃曼来说，这却不简单哦。
Although this is a very simple thing to do, it was actually not that simple for Naaman.
我是个大人物，我竟然这样的低声下气来到你的面前。
I am a great commander, and I have humbled myself to come before you.
其实我可以下命令叫你来见我的。
Actually, I could have issued an order for you to come and meet me.
但是我没有动用我的能力。
But I did not use my order.
我也可以用王的信给你看的。
I could have used the letter from the king to show it to you.
但我也是没有动用。
But I did not use it.
我可以直接进入你的家的。
I could have gone straight into your house.
但是为了表示我对你的尊重和谦卑，我站在你的门口等你。
But in order to show my respect for you and my humility, I stand at your door and wait for you.
我已经做了这么多了，那你应该也看在我这一些谦卑的份上啊。你也应该来见我了吧。
I have done so much, and on account of my humility, it is time that you come out and see me.
哪里知道伊丽莎先生根本都不理他，只是派一个仆人出来见他。 你说他气得他气得不得了的。
He did not expect that Prophet Elijah would disregard him and instead just send his messenger to him.
我们有时候也有这样的想法。
Sometimes we also think in this way.
我们以为我们对神很虔诚，我们很听话，那么神也应该听我们的话，给恩典我们呢。
We think that we have been very reverent towards God and we have been obedient. Therefore, God should also bless us and give us grace.
所以如果神不听我们的时候，不给我们恩典，我们就认为，那我们这样好，这么谦卑，这么听话，做什么呢？
And when God does not listen to our prayers and does not disobey on us, we start to question why should we continue to be obedient to God.
因此我们就反抗呢。
Then we become rebellious.
那这不是证明哦，原来我们先前的虔诚是假的。
Does not just then mean that whatever reverence that you had previously are all false.
就像乃曼生气走了，他这个生气不是表露出来，原来先前他所做一些谦卑的样子都是假的。
Just like Naaman became furious and walked away, does this not show that all the humility that he has manifested earlier was put on and was false?
因为他并不是真正因为他是神的仆人，所以尊敬他的神。
Because he did not truly respect Elijah on account that he was a servant of God.
他是尊敬以利沙能够给他的帮助啊。
He respected Elijah for the help that Elijah would be able to give him.
当然，如果以利沙真的帮助他医好他的病了，他当然会恭敬到底啊。
And if Elijah had helped him and cured him of his illness, he would have truly respected Elijah.
但是现在得不到帮助了。
But now that he could not get any help from him,
那还要这样装下去吗？
Why does he need to continue to act?
因此他就反应了，他就生气了。
So he became furious.
就像我们也是一样。
We are like that sometimes.
当我们对一个人有要求的时候，我们对他总是客客气气的。他讲什么我们都没有关系，没有关系。
When we need a favor from someone, we tend to be very polite with the person and we will be able to tolerate anything that he says.
因为我们需要他的帮助。
Because we need his help.
现在虽然不需要，不知道哪一天需要呢，还是不要得罪他好。
So even if I do not need his help today, a day may come when I will need him to help me. So I should not offend him.
这个人对我一点帮助都没有的，只是给我麻烦而已的。
But on the other hand, if there was someone whom I know I will never, who was never able to help me, but who only give me trouble,
我还要对他客客气气吗？
Do I need to be polite with him?
我还要对他不客气的，免得他来缠住我。
I should treat him badly so that he will not come and bother me anymore.
所以人的尊敬，人这种虔诚，真的是从内心的尊敬和虔诚吗？
So the reverence that we have for God, does it come from our heart?
乃曼他以为他这种的虔诚可以得到什么恩典？
Naaman thought that such reverence from him could enable him to receive grace from God.
是不能够的。
But it could not.
虔诚是我们的本分来的。
To be reverent is something that we have, it's our duty.
不能够因为我们很虔诚，所以神就一定要听我的话。
God does not have to listen to us because we are reverent.
就好像我对你客客气气，一见面就问你早安你好，难道我就希望等一下你要请我吃文春面和咖啡吗？
For example, if I'm very courteous and polite to you and I greet you, does it mean that I should be able to expect you to treat me to a meal?
乃曼虽然有这些错误的思想，
although Naaman had these wrong thoughts,
但是最后他能够悔改，他能够顺服神。
Eventually, he was able to repent and to submit to God.
当他真正放弃他的骄傲，改正他的错误的时候，
when he truly let go of his pride and repent from his wrong ways.
就是这么的单纯，照神的话去做，在洗胆和洗气次，他的病就完全得到医治了。
And with simple faith, he came before God and went through the river to wash himself. His illness was healed.
为什么我说单纯的信心呢？
Why do I think that his faith was simple?
你不要幻想哦，去洗第一次起来，好了一点点哦，那你就很有信心洗第二次哦。
We not think that as you go and wash yourself, the first time you wash yourself and you come out.And you see that you have been, you are better by a little, then you would have faith to wash yourself the second time so that you get even better.
如果你洗了三次起来哦，还是一样没有好，你还有信心继续洗第四次吗？
If by the third wash you are still unwell, would you still have faith to wash yourself a fourth time?
我们总要看到一点点的东西，那么我们才有信心继续下去，对不对？
Often we have to see a little result before we have the faith to continue on.
但是单纯的信心，不管多少次，他会完全遵照神的话，这样去做的。
But the simple and pure faith, will enable one to be completely obedient to the word of God.
所以他洗了第四次上来的时候，真的他就得到医治了。
So by the seventh time, he washed himself and came out of the water, he was healed.
我们要祈求神的恩典也是一样。
It is the same when we want to pray for the grace of God.
我们应该在神的面前真正的悔改，真正的有一种单纯的信心来信靠他。
We should truly repent before God and have this faith that is pure and simple.
你就会像乃曼一样蒙神恩典的。
Then you will be like Naaman and receive grace from God.
唱赞美诗264首。
Let us sing hymn 264.